I'm going to paint my cat Lily. I have a very, very light pencil sketch on here, and I've decided on a possible way to do the painting to come out the way I want it. The last one didn't come out exactly like I wanted it. So we'll see about this one. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to wet parts of the paper where I want color to be. Actually, this first color is just going to be black. And we'll see what it does. So this is just water, clean water. And what I want to do is I want to make the paint flow where I put the water on the paper. Pick up some black paint. This is ivory black. And tip the paper to make the paint flow a little more in the places where I want it to flow. Add a little more water. To places where I want the paint to flow. And now, I suppose I have to just hold on to the paper until it dries. Well, no. There's some other places I want black, but I really like the way that did that, and I don't really want to move it. So I'm going to try to put some water in another place where I want some black. It's on the top of the head. Okay, let's add the black, see what happens. Can move that paint around a little bit. Get a smaller brush, if I can find one, and kind of pull some of that water out to make the paint flow. The reason I sound funny is because I have a brush in my mouth. Okay, I don't know, is that enough? Nope. We need a little bit more. So I'm going to put a patch of black on her back. So I put the water down, then I just dab some paint in it and see. See where it flows. Now it won't all dry exactly as you see it. Gosh, I love that wispy edges to the paint, but I'm afraid that's not gonna be the way it always is, the way it dries, in other words. Lily is a calico cat, three colors. She showed up about 7 years ago at my house and had kittens in my closet. So at the time I named her Naughty, which was short for not my cat. Now, 7 years later, she's still here. And I said, okay, so you've been here a long time. Maybe I should give you another name. And she said, my name is Lily. So I said, fine, your name is Lily. And that's her name. All right, I think that's all the black I'm gonna put on her. So we wait for that to dry before we do anything else. The black paint that I put on here is now dry. And I've mixed up a color that is, it's gamboge, which is a yellow, and a little bit of burnt sienna added in. And this is to make the second color of the calico. I hope it works. I'm painting in just water again, and I'm covering some of the black. Because this is where I want that yellow color to arrive. Okay, we'll see what happens. Let it flow. I'm gonna add a little more water, get it to flow in a particular direction. Oh wait, I need some more yellow down here. Tilting the paper to make it flow where I want it to flow. Okay. Now there's a bunch of yellow on the face of the cat. That's a little more tricky. I'll try it. Oh, look, cat hairs in my painting. How could that happen? And put a little more water on. And some more water on the face where there is more yellow color. It's much darker around the eyes, but I'm gonna let that just, I'm gonna paint over it later and make it darker. Okay. Oh, forgot the other ear. We're gonna put that in yellow. All right, before we can paint anything else, we need to let that dry. Most of that yellow color has dried. I'm now going to paint in a few little details that I need to have dry, like the eyes. She has golden eyes, kind of golden green, but oh well, let's see if we can make a golden green. Oh, there we go. When you do the eyes, you're gonna put the black in afterwards, but you wanna leave a little bit of white for a catch light. A catch light is the reflection of light in the eye. And you'll see it when I put the black pupil on, how that catch light works. But right now I just want to make sure that this paint dries before we're ready to go in and paint the eyes. Okay. And then I'm going to put a little bit of pink on the ears and the nose. She's a little pink nose and little pink ears. And a little more pink. Too much red. Add more water. There we go. Now, before I can go anywhere near painting any of that or painting over it, I have to wait till those dry. But we can paint a few more things. I'm using the edge of a paper towel to take some of the water off the nose because it's just too wet. It would take ages to dry. Okay, good. Next thing I'm going to do is put a few black lines in. I don't like all this pink up here either. I'll dab some of that off. Just need a taste of pink. Her paws are white. So the only solution to that, to get them to show up, is to paint a line showing where they are, or to paint black in the background. So I'm taking a gray. It's just black with a lot of water added. And making some little lines that show where her legs are. And perhaps a line here too. Well, that's a little bit light, even for me. Okay. So the next thing one would do is paint the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. But we have to wait for things to dry before we can do that. Okay, the watercolor that I put on this one has dried, so now I'm going to use watercolor pens to do detail work. These pens are water-soluble pens, easy to do detail work. I'm going to use first a burnt sienna color to go around the eyes. There's a dark area around that cat's eyes. It's actually the lids of the eyes that kind of show. I've gotten one eye a little bigger than the other, so I'll just take it down a little bit. I'm going to take the hard edge off it by adding water. Now the edges of the eyeball need a little bit of shadow. Makes them look round. So I'm just brushing some of that burnt sienna color into the eye. Not sure I like that, but we'll see what happens. Okay. Might have gotten it too dark, but whatever. We'll work on it. I'm going to use the same burnt sienna to make the outline of the nose and the mouth. And once again, I'm going to soften it with water on a brush. So this watercolor pencil, watercolor pen actually acts kind of like a watercolor itself. You just lay down the color, but when you put water on it, it dissolves. Okay. I'm going to use some black watercolor pen to put some details to the ears and then I'll come back to the eyes. Soften that out a little bit with water so it's not just a hard line. You can soften it as much or as little as you like by just adding extra water. Okay. Now I have to go back to the eyes and put the pupils in. And I think I'm just gonna use a pen for that. Make sure it works. Seems to. Might not have let it dry enough. I'm going to leave a white catch light in the middle of the eye. come back and fill that in later. Okay, I need a little bit of that watercolor pen to fill in the black part. Put a little black line along the bottom of the eye. Makes it look like it has more depth. Now I should put the cat's whiskers on, but the cat's whiskers are white, which isn't going to show. Okay. So I'm done. Except I'm not. I have an idea that I could make a section of this black as if she's standing on something, and that would be nicer than just having those gray lines. So it may ruin the whole painting or not. We're about to find out because I'm gonna do it. I often turn my paintings sideways to paint just because it's easier to get the paint on sometimes. You will notice that I did not paint the black in the details close to the cat's paws. And the reason is, because I wanted that kind of brush stroke to show. And I can't get that when I'm painting real close to the paws. So we'll go back and put that in with a smaller brush. I think it's done. So, happy painting, happy trails.